EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Minnesota Vikings. Stadium. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. First carry for Josh Jacobs. And he'll push forward for about four up to the 23.
Well, you don't turn your nose up at a gain of four, do you? They'll take that on first down. Playbook's got to be pretty well open on second and six.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They'll run right here with Jacobs. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
From the gun now on third down, Carr. And that will be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. That's to his running back, complete. A strong running. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. So Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath, maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field, everyone getting their feet wet early.
On second and 11 now, Carr. That's complete to his tight end, Waller. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you...
And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he takes it all the way down to the 3. It's a big play there for Vegas. Here's Jacobs, and he's in! Touchdown, Raiders! Josh Jacobs. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. Kenny Nwangu now out of his end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Bond going to throw it. Flush to his right. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big play there for Minnesota. So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I think we got to give it up for him right there. That's a heck of an athletic move for a big man right in the middle of the line. How about the play he makes there? Nowhere to run, and he finishes that one off for a loss.
On second and 12, Mond. That's into the hands of Westbrook over the middle. And now a fumble. The ball's out, and the Raiders pick it up. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. In our meetings this week, they kind of tipped us off. They wanted to play ultra-aggressive, forcing fumbles. They just did that right there.
They took it to the next level, didn't they? You're exactly right, because everyone talks about being aggressive on defense and tackling well, but they were talking about getting after the football, making sure the ball was stripped out each and every time they lined up someone to get them on the ground.
And the adjustment working early. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. First down, Jacobs, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Making the stop there, Daniil Hunter. Here's second and 10. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Catch is made by Hunter Renfrow. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
They'll run on first down. Richard, and he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Now Carr. Quickly a slant to Renfrow. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 36.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I didn't get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play. This will be caught by Edwards. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 13-yard line. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Throwing on first down is Carr. He finds his man complete. It's Jacobs. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. Now a first carry for their fullback. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders add on to their lead. Well, it was second and goal. You're in there close. That's the fullback's comfort zone.
Not only is it his comfort zone, it's an expectation. That's what he's supposed to do. Turn and hand it to him. Big guys fire out. Find your way into the end zone.
Carlson down to add the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. Nwangu now from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Here's Mond. They'll check that down to Nwangu out of the backfield. So he stopped for no gain. And it'll be second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. To throw again on second down, Mond. Open here, Adam Thielen. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders' 22-yard line. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Mond to the air on first and 10. Drops this off with Nwangu. And he'll be pulled down as a penalty flag will rein in as well, and that would appear to be a face mask. So that, a free 15 yards.
And it's always a tough one as a defender because a lot of the penalties that you commit, pass interference, holding, when they happen, you actually know what you're doing. But a face mask penalty, a lot of times it's inadvertent, but it still costs you the same amount of yardage.
A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
They've definitely established a rhythm on this drive, moving the ball quite well. And big man with football is an integral part of the whole thing.
Once more, it's the fullback Ham. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. C.J. Ham. As the first half is winding down, and the Vikings are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Mike Zimmer's made the decision. His guys will go for two. They'll look to throw. And he's got it here for the 2 points, but there is a marker down, so we'll have to see what that's about. Charles, did I just hear that right? They declined the personal foul. 3 yards, they just declined them.
And I have to think that the official is thinking to himself, did I just hear that correctly, that you declined that one? All I can think of is that someone on the field got confused.
Must have.
It had to, because you're going to take the yards on that penalty each and every time.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Showing just 16 seconds till the half as they line up first and 10. On play action, it's Carr. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. Second and 14 as they've got work to do here after the sack. They don't want to repeat a first down. They'll keep it on the ground. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. The final shot here before half for Carr. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. And that will be incomplete. Scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. So we have reached halftime here in Vegas with the Raiders on top. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? The Vikings set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail it here as we resume play. Nwangu now from his end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2. Another run now for Nwangu. And this one will go to the 28-yard line.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
On first down, here's Mond. So the completion good for 7 there. And that'll make it a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Calling no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go. Another carry now for Madison, and they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. Just a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's 4th down. Here's Mond, they're going for it. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position. Here's Jacobs on 1st and 10. Space to run past the 20. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Josh Jacobs, his 2nd touchdown of the night, and the Raiders are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. They'll try to run it with Jacobs. And he will get into the end zone again. And he seems to have a nose for it as he gets both the touchdown and the two-point conversion. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. Nwangu now from his end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Second and 10. Mond looks to throw. His throw incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Now Mond. That'll be complete to the running back, Nwangu. And he'll be stopped short of the first down as they rally to tackle him at about the 28. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a fourth down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Open man is Westbrook, complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
He'll buy some time right. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
While you admire anyone trying to pick up an additional couple of yards, they're just not worth it when you take shots like that. Quarterbacks have to stay in the game and stay on the field.
On second down, here's Nwangu. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and 2. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Call it a gain of 2 as time has run out on this third quarter play. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. A great effort there to shed the contact, and it helps him pick up the first. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You still have to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Mond looks to throw on first down. They'll set up the screen for Nwangu. Oh, what a move. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of 4. So still 14 yards to go, second down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
He'll get this to Nwangu.
Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and they're going to have a 3rd down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Complete. Smith has it. And he's able to pick up the 1st down before he's tackled right at the 10. And in a 2-score game, obviously, every play, every 3rd down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to 3rd down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Well, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Well, Brandon, we see why it's a team game there, because there's a sigh of relief that they just released defensively. If he's able to get that one away, it's likely a touchdown. But instead, that pressure from the front got to him and forced the incompletion.
You're right. He had him open just a split second too late on the release. Well, when you're leading in the 4th quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
So now after the face mask penalty, here's 1st and goal. Cook. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Dalvin Cook taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Vikings have made it a 1-score game again here in the 4th. All right, now a big 2-point conversion attempt still to come. Cook, they'll try and run it. And he will find the end zone again. So he gets the touchdown and the 2-point conversion. And that'll cut this deficit down a little bit further. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Taken at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it 3 times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the 2-minute warning in play, so essentially 4 timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here. I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a 1st down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And he is going to lose yardage here. Now the Vikings will use the 2nd of their timeouts, as he'll get it with still 1:20 left to go in the game. So their task a little bit more difficult now. 2nd and 13 that they're walking up on. Now Carr. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
It would be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
touchdown. Ready to kick it away is Carlson. Nwangu now from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think part of their plan was to hit them over the top with the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
He's going to let it fly. Oh, a contested ball here, and it's going to be caught. And down to the 11. A big play there for Minnesota. Prime example there of how his height can be an advantage. It makes it tough on some of these smaller defensive backs.
When they try and go through that type of a receiver to get the football, oftentimes that big body, that frame will block them away. And whether the receiver has to elevate or extend, now he has a clear path to the football with the defender usually on his back. That's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
To throw again on second down, Mon. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
Boy, this crowd is on pins and needles now, because anytime you see the ball heading for the end zone, you really hold your breath, and they come out of their seats. That one falls incomplete.
Yeah, he's got it. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout, as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And it's incomplete, but a flag is down here, so hang on. Let's see what we've got. The hit comes late. We saw it. There's your flag.
And we know that there's a guideline, right? Ball's gone, you get one step. If you're within one step of the quarterback, you can hit him as long as it's still done legally. But anything outside of that, looks like an extra step was involved.
Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. They'll try and run it here. And he will pull his way in there for the 2 points. Nothing fancy there on that two-point try. Give it to the big boy and let him go to work.
That almost felt like sandlot football that we used to play, didn't it? Biggest guy on your team who can carry the ball, hand it to him and let him rumble.
Nobody picked me on the sandlot football team.
You were quarterback, and I know better.
I was the water boy. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. So this This one, a victory for the Las Vegas Raiders. And it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises. Really, both sides did. But they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind.